Hi, welcome to Brewing Wellness. My name is Purthi and this channel is all about positivity, mental health, fitness, motivation and life journey. Today's topic is a little unconventional because it is about trekking. I want to talk about how trekking and the mountains influenced my life in many positive ways. My first ever trek was the Rupkund trek back in 2018. So stick around till the end to know how it impacted my life forever. The Rupkund trek is known to be one of the hardest treks in the Himalayas. So let me take you through the entire journey.
This is where Rupkund is located in India. It is deep inside the Himalayas. To be precise, it belongs to the Gadwal region of the mountains. The journey starts from the base camp called Lohajung, but to get to Lohajung, it takes about 2 days from Bangalore. From Bangalore, I had to make my way to Delhi and then to a place called Kathgodam. We had a pickup from Kathgodam to Lohajung that was arranged by Thrillophilia, the booking partner. We started our trek from Lohajung and reached Wan. From Wan, we made our way to Ali Bugyal, which is beautiful as you can see. Lots of lovely meadows and greenery. From there, we continued to Bedni Bugyal. It is very important to get acclimatized, so we stayed at Bedni Bugyal for a day and then went to Pathar Nachni the next day. The trek to Pathar Nachni from Bedni Bugyal took an entire day. There was this beautiful spot where I took this picture. I love bungee jumping and I don't have a phobia of heights. But standing on this rock made me super giddy and I'm never going to forget the feeling it gave me. The view from Pathar Nachni was amazing, as you can see here. I practiced a few asanas at Pathar Nachni just for pictures. It's amazing how clearly I remember this journey. It's like I was there just yesterday. We stayed at Pathar Nachni for a night and the next day we continued towards Bhagwabasa. Once we reached Bhagwabasa, it was like a whole different trek that just began. From the temperature, the feel of the landscape and the view, everything suddenly changed. So we had our dinner at about 9 p.m. and slept till 1:30 and started our journey at 2 a.m. only because we had to make it on time for the sunrise. But guess what? It was a super cloudy day and we couldn't really see the sunrise, but we had a beautiful experience, as you can tell. By the time we reached the summit, our fingers and toes had started turning blue and they were numb. This place is out of the world. It is also known as the Mystery Lake because there are skeletons lying there which are more than 100 years old. It was freaky but still gave me an adrenaline rush. We stayed at the summit for about 30 minutes before we could not take the cold anymore and then started our descent. It's a magical feeling.
Rup stands for beauty and Kund means pond. So there is a beautiful story involving Lord Shiva and Ma Parvati as to why this trek or this mystery lake is called Rupkund. One day while Goddess Parvati was getting ready, she was looking for her mirror and she could not find it. So she approached Lord Shiva asking for a mirror to check if she's looking okay. What he did was create a pond or a kund in the Himalayas with his Trishul so that his wife, Goddess Parvati, could take a look at herself. And we all know how beautiful Goddess Parvati is, which is why this pond or this mystery lake was called Rupkund since then. Here's the crux of the video. The reason why I got addicted to trekking and exploring mountains is really because the kind of perspective shift it gave me. As humans, we have a lot to deal with and life doesn't always go as planned. We create mountains of worries and stress in our head to an extent where we feel frozen. And when I did my first trek and completed it successfully, I realized that standing in front of these majestic mountains, our worries and our issues in life are really not that big. And all we have to do is try and understand that maybe 10 years from now or 5 years from now, the issues that are worrying us are not going to matter. This was a huge paradigm shift for me. The mountains teach you how beautiful life can be and how small we are in front of nature. And trekking the Himalayas gives you a sense of self-confidence and self-worth that no other activity can give you, according to me. And when I'm able to successfully complete the trek and summit the mountain and come back safely, it is the biggest feeling of achievement ever. If you want to see more such videos of my other treks, please let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It would mean a lot to me. Thank you so much for watching. Have a beautiful day. I'll see you in the next video.